do, we're trying to understand this idea or begin more of a long range plan, because this, again, if something's big, heavy coming in, we're looking at this idea of stopping it. Now we've got this idea of it's very open. Anything that's on my head, block, knock out the way, and then it. Because you can get quite a bit of. Just get the long one. A cheap one. No, I don't want to hurt. Yeah, yeah. Just hold it, there. So you can get quite a bit of energy just in that. So you just, and then coming through, so it's this.
Makes the way free.
Yeah, a bit like a lasso. It doesn't need much. All you need to do is to make a little space to attack.
It sounds a little complicated. I mean, but that is the Schwung, also from the Anfang.
Yeah.
Not from that string. So instead of doing that one.
That's what I'm saying, like that, if you think something really heavy.
Would you say this is...
Against something that's coming in. And this is better. You know, you get the order you used to have, these used to be actually made of solid metal.
Yeah, so you don't rely on the strength in your wrist, but...
You're relying on the strength of the arm to stop that.
Right.
So that's why we need that, because as I say, these weapons are... heavy things,
yeah, I know them.
Yeah. You need to send again when you bring something around or this sort of length. So then now you're talking about coming, then sweeping change and coming sweeping. Oh, now we need to basically stop something here.
Yes.
Then knock it out and then again.
Yeah, right.
So again, you're talking about these big, heavy metal things that are coming in. So this is what. No, they were around in those days. So we need to think about protecting against something. And this is why you need this change in the protection. Mm. This is how I'm thinking anyway.
No, I mean, now it's really logical. Mm. The principle is to use the body and not...
No, that's weird, because that's... Because there, you use that tool, you jump as well, and that's just... it's enough. These things, you know, a lot of momentum in the angle. And you're not even gonna...
after protecting.
So he might use this one. I don't want to chop chunks out of his next one.
This thing works.
And then du abgewehrt hast. Und dann machst du ja einmal den Weg frei.
Genau, du musst dann hier machen.
Which hand schlägt?
Die obere du schlägt daneben, die untere dreht und schlägt.
Ja.
Also du bist.
Ja. That, yeah. Yeah.
The one that's furthest out.
Yeah.
One that's out.
Right.
Strikes. And changes.
Okay. Ja. Das ist ja, auch anders. In der anderen Form machen wir auch einmal so und schlagen mit der gleichen Hand.
Nee, stimmt nicht. Der ist in der
anderen Form. The hand is out.
Ja.
Der kommt schon zurück. Ist in der anderen Form.
Ja.
Können wir nochmal machen? So, beide drehen.
Ja.
So mit Schneiden von unten.
Ja.
Block oben.
Aha.
So beide Blocken, also nicht nur nicht vorne, sondern beide Blocken.
Okay.
Links schlägt ihn zur Seite, rechts dreht, schlagen.
Ja.
Und zurück.
Next section is always a nice relaxing one. It's like the calm before the storm. And
what
does
it get? No, sorry.
Mando. No.
That's the easy one.
This one, I've sometimes you have chundos with 1, 2, 3 steps forward, but it's not.
Yeah, it's basically
optional.
The Yip-Ching version, if I recall. Yeah, there was a second reason why you're doing this.
Not this yet.
Yeah, that's
it's almost like more like that, isn't it? It's more from the wrist. I think I've seen it, it's more from the wrist.
Yeah, no.
This one again, we're looking at the mantle again, because this idea of you're basically just stepping right in. It's a big long step, a big long cut.
Yeah.
Leg off the first section. It's not like this type of thing. It's a big entry technique that you come in with it. I prefer just to do a single one because to use this big long step. So we're looking at this when they're standing up. One coming from there, knock something out of the way, and then so it's quite simple. It's just idea of get in. If there's a weapon out of the way, knock it out of the way and hit it. So rather than thinking of it as three, it's just you practice doing as many as you want, up and down, depends how long the room is. Now we come to no. What we're looking at here is this is a full lap to this point here, and it's straight, it's in line here, and this is on centre line, and then come back to centre. So we do four of those. So it's cut one, cut two, cut three, cut four, and then back to the centre. To me, again, what are we changing for? Why change to do this? Why should we take the risk? We've got this change for a defensive reason. Now, me being the psycho that I am, I'm thinking, again, we're looking at armor. I'm thinking of, from here, what I'm looking to do when I change is that this is why it's about one full weighted cut and another full weighted cut. Now, sorry, now see where the two legs are. There's two legs that are down there, and that's what we're looking at.
A lot of legs, still.
But you're putting those legs on joints, on either the shoulder or the neck. So we're looking into cutting into areas. So if I'm going to cut in, I'm looking to step in and cut down a weak point and hit the weak point again. This is my thinking. I don't know anybody else who talks this way, just psychos like me. But this is, if I'm going to do it, this is what, if you've got thick leather armour on, or bamboo armour, whatever type of, sometimes you're going in for battle, you're going with shorts and your t-shirt on, come on, I'm going to have you. You know, it's like so to me this is what we're looking at. So this is what from here when we're looking at the foot, what I do is, so it's a cut and a cut that follows. So when it changes, it's a cut and a cut that follows down the same line. It's a cut and a cut that follows down the same line. It's a full cut and a power cut using the body. So now I'm coming in with this one body weight as well. So not only have I weakened the point, I'm hitting in with my whole body weight. So I've got to be able to do some damage with that. Now this is the way I think of using the cup toe. So going forward, as we go forward, it's the last section we look at to find the centre line. We step in, 1, 2, change it to the double one, kick, and then like a lando. The lower one changes, out to here, double change, back to here, knock it away, and spread. One, two, three, and back in position. So again, out. One, cut, cut. Two, cut, cut. Change, kick through. And one, two, clear. Back, two, three, there, and finish.
It's a third version.
You've heard it. This is the first version I was taught, and it's the one I've stayed with.
One of them.
To me, I disagree. I mean, like, as I say, I do it my way, my thinking. People's thoughts on this are interesting, but for me, I've got to give a good reason for everything I do in all my weight camp.
Yeah.
Not just the night form, but in the pole form, the dummy, Sulentel, Chunky, Beauty, everything.
Yeah.
It's got to have a reason because I understand the mechanics, the structure, the function. Not because Sifu says, Yip Chun says, or Yip Ching says, Yip Man did so. That's not an argument for me. So, it's like, I remember back in 1985, I did a seminar with a whole weekend with Dan and Sandler, the new streamer, and Deep Hunter. And he said, he was honest, he said, look, you know, with a screamer, you can make it up yourself. Experience, because all it is the figure of eight down, figure of eight up, and across, up and down, side to side, poke that way, poke with that bit. What else can you do? There's not a lot to it, and so there, but there's not a lot to our bodies, and there's not an awful lot. It's weapons are relatively simple. I mean, this is quite complicated. And again, now I ask the question, why the complication? So you have to look at the weapons that you're fighting at the time. Why should we do it? What makes sense? This seems like this is for a three sectional staff. I go against somebody with a three sectional staff, put on either leg sword. One of my students was very good with the double lunge jacks. Really, amazing fast. The double, the two, you can do it the same thing. He says, wait, okay, tell me what. He says, we'll have a fight. You have your double lunge jacks, two lunge jacks, I have nothing. I say, but I come in, and if I come in, if you take that, I will hurt you. Because again, I know that, what are you going to do with it? On the way in, where are you going to hit it? How many times are you going to be able to hit it? By the time I get in here. Because I'm not going to stand there, but I'm going to, I'm going to make the distance up so quickly, so. Okay, I might break my arm. Yeah. So, yeah. I'll take a broken arm, a broken leg, or you're going to die. This is fighting, this is battle, this is like reality. And this is what I always look at myself when I'm doing things. So that's why, again, so you don't know. As I say, you've got to think that's not it. If you got, again, my understanding of the pole form, I have a good, I've my reasons for doing it, and I don't deny other people their reasons. But I can say why I'm doing my. And that's why I like this knife form. It's not exactly the way Yip Chun showed me, but it's almost exactly the way Yip Chun showed me. But to me, I've tightened up the angles. I focus more on no gaps, more about energies everywhere.
Yeah.
And thinking about the structures that I'm actually using together. And this to me is Wing Chun. Give me a time with any button, And I was finding a way to use it quite well. Just do that. But this is how, again, to me, the reality side of Wing Chun. It's got to be sensitive, it's got to be logical.
Yeah.
Not just because somebody says, Yip Man said so. And not just because it looks violent. You see, a gun doesn't look very violent until you pull the trigger. Why? Hey. I always say, if you really want to hit somebody, you should always smile just before you do it. Don't tell us, oh, I'm going to hit you, I'm going to hit you. Hit them. It's about knowledge, it's about understanding, it's about feeling. But I once nearly dropped, I was the first time.
Well, I have too much energy.
The very first, because I did the first proper full performance of the Knife Form in the UK. Would be 1985 in Birmingham. And that was the year that Yip Chun taught me and Sipu. Because again, he showed me and Sipu with an hour and a half, and Sipu was back on. So he showed it. He didn't show me the last section, but where Sipu was learning. So I can't say that Yip Chun showed me the whole form. But while Sipu was being shown by Yip Chun, I was watching on the video and learning off the video. So. But we're doing this demonstration and getting the wood. We're doing this bit, so I've done getting right towards the end and sitting there quite heavy at night, and you're getting a bit tired and quite sweaty, and you're sort of doing this bit. And this last, and then he dropped the knife. Fortunately for this young boy sitting there, whose head was about to, I would have speared this young boy's head. Because there was a lot of people in the audience, and I'd obviously come up, I'd stepped a bit forward, and I was like, that's where I got, the scripts that you have for tennis rackets and squash rackets and stuff. Yeah. It makes sense, not just normal, like straight, like, but it was a stainless steel, as well as mine. And so, that was a wake up call to get some crap on my handles.
There's much stuff in there.
Yeah, so you have here the thing, for the tennis schläger.
Yeah.
The bandage band.
Here though?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Knife from Sam Kwok.
Yeah.
We buy everything in China for steel. Right?
Yeah.
That's a more than butterboard machine.
Ja, ganz locker.
Hast du noch ein paar Formen vor dir?
Ja, das ist was.
I did two shows, that's why he's also a lot. It's too short, because that's why here I would lose. Should be. We have to be more than Yuri. But today it's a bit of a blend in between the two. You need that idea of what you've got when you're doing, when you're covering. you don't want to blade that lands there and you stop something. Well, this one is like upright for me.
Yeah, the left is alright, but
the grips is not very good. So it makes it more difficult to get this back together.
Yeah.
It's no full handle, it's a half a handle.
Yeah, it's a half handle because they sit together.
Together, it's a double. Yeah.
Yeah. That's why they're supposed to sit together. It's also quite useful because when I used to take them teaching at school, well, there's times when I could not be bothered to take my case. We just gotta be careful in a second out of there. So you get stopped, some people on the show are like, fucking hell, Dundee? Yeah. Oh, you go over there, hey, no, you call it a night? This is a night. What do you call that, mate?
It's easy, mate.
Well, I used to carry them to my classes.
This is a proper
technique.
That's the white one. What do you want to do? You think it'll happen.
As you will make it.
Beide drehen?
Drehen.
Der untere schneidet, dann kannst du gut ein bisschen weiter drehen, dass nicht so steht, sondern wo du dir vorstellst, ne, kannst du gut ein bisschen weiter drehen, einfach wie in der Reichweite, dass nicht so steht.
Und dann? Dann noch ein bisschen so. Was hast du gemacht? Beide drehen. So, bei dem kannst du ruhig ein bisschen, nicht so eng, kannst du ruhig ein bisschen, dass du auch wirklich die ja. Power hast. So, von hier beide Blocken, oberer dreht, unten dreht, dann.
Seltsam.
Vielleicht, oder?
Ja, das auch. Nee, wie das auch gefühlt, ich war gar nicht.
Yeah, it's one of these things you stick to school. That's what I mean. You know, this whole like, idea of just slicing somebody open from like beginning. It's more like this.
Pulling straight up. Yeah.
It's, yeah, it's not. I mean, it's not that original, but that it's the simplicity of fighting.
You can do more with what we've got. That's all we learned in a scream on it.
But that's what I mean. Again, it's just. There's restrictions on certain things, and I mean, all you have to do is understand those restrictions. So to me, that's my identity. That's my main life form is like, to say it's almost identical to the way I was first shown it. And your pulse changed days more than I have. Just from that first 10-year-old showing it. Your pulse form has changed more. But as I say, I focus on more on the details of what I want to give. Some reason of what this is for, what am I doing this for. And so it's a whole difference in, so that, and then it helps you visualize and apply even your heart. So it's not just restricted to a butterfly form, which is you're never going to put across it. You're not going to use on the street. Like you're not more than likely. After Derry did years ago. I was at a tattoo convention and we're doing a demonstration of because at the time I was doing it was a sports science qualification. And the guy who organized this demonstration at a tattoo convention. A few months before, one of my students had been was in a bar that he was not run. And Hell's Angels came in. Mm. These Hell's Angels came in and sort of like because the barmaid wouldn't serve them at that time, he beat her up severely. Her husband then came, and then they beat the husband up, and he brought a machete from him because he was in a fight, but he chopped him up with a machete. But anyway, but my student was the witness to him, because they weren't proper Hell's Angels, were like prospects. But again, but because it was Hell's Angels, but they were at this tattoo convention, and they saw Neil, and at least at any one time, 17 Hell's Angels and around them. They're all drinking Edinburgh water, we're all drinking beer. And but I was doing this demonstration, I had my names there, so I had them in the bar ready. And there was a guy who had organised the event, he was talking, so I'm talking to Hell's Angels. And they were funny, so they knew I was there. So I think what they were waiting for was for somebody to turn up and get some witness. So I said, look at this and I said, where does this go? Where does this go? I'm not staying here. I know it's going to be weird for it. Yeah. That's what we're talking about, so we just... That's not happening, but that's what we're talking about. So the Nelly got some use.
Yeah.